I wish to thank the viewers for selecting my video lecture on viscosity. In today's topic, we are going to see how viscosity of a fluid behaves. Before going into the actual topic, let's understand what is viscosity is. Viscosity is actually a fluid property which is realized when there is a motion of fluid. So before understanding viscosity, let's understand few parameters like shear stress, force, intermolecular attraction, and cohesion. So first I will explain what is shear stress. So I am considering two layers of fluid. Say this is my layer 1 and this is my layer 2. Layer 1 is moving at a velocity of u1 and layer 2 is moving at a velocity of u2, and u2 is greater than u1. This is my scenario now. So because of this relative velocity between the layer 2 and layer 1, there is a, as per Newton's law, I have a force that is acting here, and this particular force of layer 1 is tending this layer also to move in the same velocity. Similarly, as per Newton, there is equal and opposite force that is created. Okay, so a force F that is created by layer 2 on layer 1 has a equal and opposite reactant force, that is R, which is equal to F, acts on the reverse direction. Okay, so this is what is called as shear stress. Shear stress tau, which is equal to force acting on a unit area. So this is the actual concept of shear stress in fluid mechanics. That is, layer 2 expresses because it travels at a velocity 2, and layer 1 which travels at velocity 1, and u2 is less than u1, there is a force that is created because of layer 2 and layer 1, and because of this force, an equal and opposite reaction force is created, that is R. Okay, so this is what is called as shear stress. Let's understand the concept of shear stress in detail for fluid mechanics and how its particle behave. For example, I am assuming a pipe and there is no fluid flow happening here. Now we introduce a bubble at this point and I allow it to float. What happens now is, because there is no free stream velocity, what happens is the bubble travels vertically up. Okay. Imagine a similar situation wherein I allow a fluid flow happening, that is, there is a flow that is happening inside this pipe. I introduce the same bubble at this point and I allow it to float to the top. Then I notice its path, I observe that instead the second portion which was at this point has moved here because it has moved at a velocity. Similarly, at third point is here, fourth point is here, fifth point is here, sixth point is here, seventh point is here, ninth point. So when you plot it, the curves being formed. Okay. Now let's compare these two, that is without flow and with flow. Okay. So this is obviously at zero velocity. So this is having a velocity u1, u2, u3, u4, u5 and u6. In order to understand the velocity, it is very much evident when you see this, that the velocity gradually increases from this point and to the till it reaches the boundary layer. This layer is the boundary layer. So what happens here is, actually when you compare between these two, that is u1 and u2, say this is my u1 and this is my u2, when I see the linear location, so this is u2 minus u1. Okay, that is, you take it as del u. Okay, and this, which is the vertical direction, that is the distance away from this end, that is, let it be y1 and y2. That is, this is my y1 and this is my y2. So this difference is y2 minus y1, or otherwise we will call it as del y. When you plot or find out the ratio between dou y and dou u, we call that is our shear stress. That is, shear stress is directly proportional to the velocity component divided by your vertical component. Okay, so this is the actual expression for shear stress that is proposed by Newton. Okay, so now, in order to eliminate, we have a proportionality constant, that is mu, introduced into du by dy. Okay, so this is your constant of proportionality, are called as your dynamic viscosity. Fine. So this is how your shear stress actually works. Having understood shear stress and force, let's see another topic called intermolecular attraction and cohesion. Here what I am doing is I am again imagining two layers of fluid, that is layer 1 and layer 2 again, layer 2 and layer 1. And layer 2 is moving at velocity u2 and layer 1 is moving at velocity u1, and the given condition is u2 is greater than u1, that is my layer 2 travels at higher velocity when compared to layer 1. Here let's understand how the fluid particle behaves. For example, the layer 2 tends to attract the molecules that is beside it, and it tends to move in the same momentum. For example, I say there are few molecules that is traveling from layer 1 to layer 1, layer from layer 2 to layer 1, and there are few molecules that are traveling from layer 1 to from layer 1 to layer 2. Now what happens is these molecules that is in the void that tends to attract because of the momentum, and this starts accelerating, that is these molecules that is adjacent to the layer 1 starts increasing the momentum and is compensating to the momentum of layer 2, whereas when you see the reverse, like the layer 2 molecules or the particles starts decelerating the molecules of layer 1. So this is the actual molecular transfer that is happening between layer 2 and layer 1, because of which we experience shear stress. Okay. So this is what we call as intermolecular attraction, and this particular intermolecular attraction is more whenever we heat this. For example, if the temperature is more, what happens here is the intermolecular attraction or the thermal transfer, because of the thermal transfer, the molecules starts colliding at a faster rate. So that is where your viscosity is inversely proportional to temperature. For liquids, what happens is the intermolecular attraction is broken down because of the increase in temperature and your velocity and drop. Whereas for gases, it is the reverse, that is increases with temperature. Okay, so because the cohesive force is more in case of gases. Okay, so having understood the viscosity concept by means of these four parameters like shear stress, force, intermolecular attraction and cohesion, let's see a demonstrative model specifically developed for this.
Acid base titration, acid base titration, acid base titration, acid base titration.